Hello, I'm Julia Cordova. Thank you so much for subscribing to my YouTube channel. I know I publish it on Twitter anyway, but I really appreciate the support. So today, I thought I would talk about something that didn't make a whole lot of sense to me as a new trader. It makes more sense to me now, and I'm going to tell you why, but that is that price action never seems to move, at least when you think it would, in the direction of news. You know, I said in an interview I did right around Valentine's Day, right before Valentine's Day, I'm like, coronavirus, that's bearish. And it was, but I don't know. I don't feel like it was that far of a stretch for me to see what was going on somewhere and that it would move here. I don't think I'm like a rocket scientist or anything, but the market just kept melting up. For some period of time after the news comes out, it seems like it just moves, it just doesn't make sense. And so it didn't make sense to me as a new trader, and it does now, and here's why. I mean, if you think about how the markets run, it's run by a very sophisticated set of computers all battling it out, and they don't think like a person, they think like a psychopath. They think in a way that is going to enable them to take as much money of yours as is psychopathically possible. And so they really just try to screw the most amount of people, whether you're on the right side or the wrong side, they're going to try to screw you out of whatever trade that you're in. I thought it'd be fun to talk about a few sort of psychopath type scenarios that I could see happening based on just what I'm seeing in sentiment and what I'm seeing in price action. And you know, it's not good to trade off of like what you think will happen. It's always best to trade off of what's actually happening, but it's nice, and I don't know, for me to have in the back of my mind sort of a projected scenario and to go from there. So with that said, let's go ahead and start by looking at ES. Mm-mm-mm. Okay, so all right, so this was quite a turnaround here. I don't really have any support there. I like everybody else in the known universe, everything in my being says that the market's going to go lower. That's probably a smart bet right now, because the trend, as you can see right now, is lower. But when does a trend change, or when does a sort of a reversal here become a trend change? When can we what do we think will happen? So let's discuss. I mean, just looking at these candles and the projection there, this seems like a Captain Obvious turnaround back to being gloom and doom. And I would say that probably because of this price action, most people, in fact, right now are bearish. Definitely most people on my Twitter feed are extremely bearish. So how can they screw bears and also screw bulls at the same time? Well, they've already screwed bulls. But seriously, what could happen here? I mean, everybody is sort of projecting, even if you're bullish right now, the projections are that, oh, okay, well, we'll go, you know, we'll kind of screw around here on Monday and then, or, you know, and turn around and maybe we'll screw some people and then go back to 2700 or 2720. That's a number a lot of people have. It happens to coincide with one of my pivots. But that also is Captain Obvious. So that bull scenario right now, where it would sort of go back here to, you know, 2720 and then go down, that seems like it would be a gift for bears, and it seems like that would be Captain Obvious for bulls. The Captain Obvious play on Friday was to call the top here. Again, that seems like, you know, high. That's very obvious. So what could actually happen is perhaps we could come back down here to even, you know, 2350 or so, and kind of mess around over here, and then it's not obvious on this time frame, but on a smaller time frame, potentially form a head and shoulders or something thereof that would screw the new bulls out of their positions and then come back around and screw bears. So I'm going to go on record here and say that I'm a little bit bullish right now. I don't want to be. It doesn't seem like the smart thing to do. I have a pretty good entry point, and I've taken partial profit along the way. But it seems to me that the way to screw the most amount of people imminently, or the most immediate way, would actually be to come up and even past 2720. Maybe come up to 2720, start to head back down, and all the bulls are like, oh God, thank you, Laura. And then, boop, right up there. That is what I would do if I were a psychopath. Yeah, that's what I would do if I was a psychopath. I would have it maybe come around. Well, it depends on how much time I had to be a psychopath. One measure would be to come back down, then go back up way past this, and then come back down and go back up. And I mean, clearly based on some of the volatility, it's absolutely possible. Or it could just go, another scenario is it could just have trapped some bulls and then go way back down here to, you know, the 2000 area. That's also a possibility. So the key, I think, in day-to-day trading is not to get too ahead of yourself, not to keep thinking, and I do this, I have to stop myself all the time. I'm right, I'm right, I'm right. A lot of times I am right, it's like scary, but I'm not right all the time. And if you get yourself thinking that you're right all the time, that's when, you know, they say, I talk about partial profits all the time, but that's when people say, man, it only takes one huge loss to wipe out all those profits, and that is true. And those huge losses, in my experience, are from me believing so long that I am right, even if I am, and it's gonna turn back around and be right, that it's gonna cause me to have big losses. So the key is just to go level to level, but in the back of your mind, it's impossible not to have some sort of bias. If maybe y'all might be better at it than I am, but that's just how I think. I think in biases. So, yeah, I'm bullish for this week. I think we're going to end this week above where we started this week. I think that would be good for everybody. Except for if you maybe went short right in this area. But let's see what happens. I certainly can think of a lot of things that can go wrong. Another shoe to drop, so to speak. I mean, I even posted that last week, last Friday on Twitter, maybe it's last weekend, where it's just like, oh, this other thing could happen, and this thing, and there's so many things that could go wrong. But the thing is, everybody is talking about them. Everybody knows it. So I would imagine that if those things were going to go wrong, they would go wrong at an extremely inopportune time for a lot of people who had reversed positions. But let's see. Open mind, level to level, we'll see what happens. Okay, now let's talk about gold. Look at that beautiful bull flag looking thing. It's quite beautiful. I think somebody asked me my opinion about it a while ago, and I said it had made a higher low. And it really tested the ambulance line, and then it just went beautiful again. And I didn't respect it for a while, so I can't pretend to, it didn't respect it for a while, but then it seemed like it was like, oh yeah, that's a line. That's an important line. So, and then when it broke up over the key, that was like gotcha. Because especially it looks like kind of a warped double bottom, but I mean, with a higher low. So that's beautiful whenever those things happen. And also these big tail things that you see, that's like always a good sign, you know? Okay, so right now the level I'm watching is a martini line, because I think that would be, if you look at this too, look, what does that look like? a possible huge ass head and shoulders. So below the Martini line, which is about 1611-ish right now, I don't know if it'll get there, but if it did, I'd look to buy it at these two little orange lines again, in the hopes that it would still be, it's quite bullish overall above the key, and in hopes that it would bounce up from there, even though it would be, I mean, depending on how it does it, but I would hope that if it didn't, if it did bounce down here, this thing by then would be up here and it would all coincide together and it would be a nice place for a long entry, to scalp at least. Or if it breaks out from here, I mean, anything I think above 1650 or so would also be a buy, at least short term, with stops, but because it would be a breakout. And I mean, even the RSI looks like a bull flag here. So I'd have to watch all of this in unison, and I will post it on Twitter. But yeah, like, I mean, it's no secret I'm a gold bull. If it failed though, these lines, and then failed the key, oh, bye-bye. We switch our bias at that time, but that time has not come. And I am trying, just so you know, to get a Bloomberg nerd, my Bloomberg nerd, I call him mine, he's not really, but like a guy who knows a lot about the why thing, to be interviewed by me, because everybody's asking me why the physical price of all the precious metals is so far off of the trading price. I don't know. But I know he knows, and I can ask him questions about that. So hopefully he'll get approval from his legal team to come on my little silly YouTube channel, and then we can ask him all sorts of questions. I will absolutely ask him whatever you want me to ask him, as long as it's not weird. And even if it's weird, as long as it's like productive, why not? I'll ask him anything. Okay, so that is gold. I continue to be bullish gold. And that's it. So silver now, last time I did any kind of charting, I actually drew in a gift line here, which is not the most optimal of gifts, I have to say, because then it went like way down right after I drew that, way down, the next day. But you know, like all, it's just a more volatile kind of, it's just a more volatile precious metal. I mean, my view for silver also remains bullish. You know, if I were silver and I had made a trajectory like this, I'd probably bull flag, similar to what happened here and there, but didn't break out. But it makes sense after any sort of upswing like that, especially because it didn't bear flag, that it would consolidate here before going higher or lower. So I would look for to form sort of a bull flag here, fill in this gap that it left. That would be buying the wheelchair line. And today that value would be about 14.117 or so. And I mean, it could certainly go all in here, but let's see what happens. I mean, it could even, you know, fill out these two lines that I've drawn. That would be cool. That'd be sexy. I'd be into that. But that's what I'm watching today. Let's see if, let's see what happens. It could certainly just continue going up. If it did go up past this gift line, which is here 14.81, I would scalp it higher because that's fairly bullish. But I do think it needs more time before it does that. I think it needs to settle down a little bit. We'll see what happens. Okay. Oh, you ready to talk about oil? What? You know, I pride myself on bottom catching, and I have not caught it. And I respect those that did. I hope that you took partial profits. I mean, maybe it is the bottom. It's still, I don't think it's reached a new low yet. But it, and I've said over and over when people ask me about it on Twitter, I'm like, I don't know. And that's true. I mean, I try not to say things unless it has a high probability, I try not to say things. But here, personally, it's just, I'm not going to say it's definitively going lower. It looks to me like it's going lower. These are some of the pivots that I'm watching. I'll publish them on Twitter later. I'm not ready to buy it yet. I need to see some real pain. And I know this is painful for a lot of people, a lot of companies, but I think the origination of the price war is to cause pain. I don't think it's caused enough pain yet. I don't know, maybe. But I'll certainly say when I go long, at this point, I would either go long on a bottom catch if it looked appealing to me when it hits one of these pivots, or I would wait until it looks more bullish and I would buy it when it looks more bullish. I know that's crazy. I know a lot of you think I'm like super brave. I'm not brave at all. I just only trade what I'm used to in terms of high probability profitable trading, and I just don't see it going up yet. But I hope it does for you guys, because I would happily buy it on a nice setup going north. I just don't think so. And also, a lot of people called the bottom at the same time, and that makes me really nervous. I did really good in catching the 26 bottom that happened before, but yeah, I get nervous when a lot of people have the same idea, and then a lot of people are like, winning, like the bears are right now in ES. I get nervous when a lot of people are on the same side. It doesn't mean that they're not right, because, I mean, look how all the bulls were right a long time. I mean, I turned bearish for the market in, like, September. I'm like, I'm not going to short it, but I'm not going to buy this crazy thing. That seems dumb. To me, I mean, so anyway, so let's look at oil in a shorter time frame here. Let's see. So, like, not bullish at this time, peoples, not bullish at this time, but let's look. Looks like it bounced off some pretty numbers here. So I'd look for it to hold there if it came back down. That'd be nice, right? If it came back down and then went back up and we had a nice tail off of that line. But let's do this. Let's see if this holds. If it doesn't, then, well, it's up against what I call absolute resistance, which is a line I draw in there that just, this looks like a really crappy chart if y'all haven't been following me, but I drew this line in there because I just consider this sort of an overall absolute pivot, and right now it's at resistance. And if it comes back down and ends the candle below this sort of divergence resistance, yeah, I wouldn't long it, but I certainly have been wrong before, so I don't see a setup here for me, but there are plenty of people I know that bought it and did well. I just don't see it for me. I will tell you, I know a lot of people ask me all the time, I will tell you when I buy it. I just like to buy it when I'm more certain of things. And I should draw in some up lines here. I don't have any right now. Let's see. Oh, what's happening there? Let me get that better. What? Huh. Well, damn, I'm good. That was like, I'm not that good because I didn't trade it, but let's see. Let's see what happens. Let's see if I can get back above 21.97 or so. And if so, looks like it would have broken out of this resistance. Mm-hmm. I like it. Okay. Now we have another trade we're watching set up for a scalp. Don't get ahead of yourselves. Another thing is, if you are buying what could potentially be a trend change, whatever market it's in, even if you are so sure that it's not going to go down anymore, up anymore, it's such a good idea to scale in, because it's just a really good idea to scale in, so that in the off chance you might be incorrect, it will help you. So to scale in, because then you'll have more ammunition, and also because then you won't lose as much in case you might be wrong about a trend change. Otherwise, just partial profits. Don't get greedy. Don't think too much ahead. Don't convince yourself you're right. Just take your money when you have it. That's it. So let me just do one other thing. I'll keep making this line bigger in case, but I would be cautiously optimistic on a scalp above 21.97. Sure, I would. Okay, well, that's it. I hope I said something smart. I hope that you were able to get something from it. I know I did. I think just saying things out loud makes me smarter sometimes, because I can hear myself disagreeing with myself. But that's it. I hope you're having a wonderful weekend and staying safe and healthy. And take care, everybody. Bye.